Good morning, students. I am welcoming you for the upcoming semester, that is by sixth semester. The subject code is 20-65-3, Advanced Industrial Automation and Building Automation. The main credit for this course, it is 3 credit. So per week, it will be a 2 theory and 2 lab slots has been allocated. So the main objective of this course, it will be you are going to study a theoretical concept in automation for building purpose. The same you are going to do it in practical way. So theory versus practical. Okay. So you know my name, that is I am Dr. Vinod, associate professor from Tripoli department. I am handling this particular course for this semester. The main course outcome for this course, to understand the architecture of advanced industrial automation system and SCADA. The second course outcome will be you are going to study the elements of building automation system. And third one, in building automation system, what are the safety precautions? That is nothing but fire alarm system and their components. The fourth course outcome will be a CCTV and access control system. Fifth course outcome will be understand the various security system for home automation. Sixth course outcome will be design and develop a basic CBUS applications for building application management. So there are 5 modules are available for this particular course. The first module will be the introduction to advanced PLC and SCADA. So SCADA means it will be a supervisory control and data acquisition. Okay, and how we are going to do the SCADA block diagram functions and what are the parameters are there, that everything we are going to discuss in module number 1. And there are practical activity, there are 4 experiments we are going to do it by using the SCADA in the Schneider laboratory. Okay, in module number 2, by using SCADA, now we are going to get into the building management system. Building management means it will be a building automation. We can say it will be called BMS, building management system. So what are the functions of building management system and what are the architectures and how the building management system will be effectively taken place. Okay, effectively that we are going to discuss it. And there are 3 experiments you are going to do it here also. The design of EMS and the BMS and the configuration of EMS and BMS. EMS stands for energy management system, BMS stands for building management system, and application with Schneider software. Okay, and for module 3, we are going to discuss fire alarm system and what are the components and why we need fire alarm system, what are the different types of fire alarm system, how it will be designed and how it will be connected in practical mode, that is in module number 3. Module number 4, it will be CCTV camera which is fixed in the buildings and how to access this CCTV camera. Okay, that is nothing but access control system, that is ACS, and how once the CCTV will be recording and how it will be stored, the images and videos, how it will be stored, and what are the different types of cameras are there and what type of lenses are using and by using which standard they are follow. That every detail we are going to study in CCTV. Here also there are 3 experiments we are going to do it. And fifth module will be home automation system. Now by using module 1, module 2, module 3 and module 4, we are going to execute a home automation system. Okay, that is nothing but here you are going to use a RFID and the security aspects we are going to design it. Okay, so this all the 5 module will be hands-on session in laboratory, and the theoretical, yeah, there will be a small theory content will be there. That's what they have allocated 2 hours per week, and remaining are practical. So this subject is very interesting for you to pursue your 7th semester and 8th semester, as well as you can easily to identify the projects by using this particular core paper. You see this architecture. This is the small building. Okay, this is the advanced building which we are constructing in nowadays. If you take any building, they are having a automatic door. Okay, there will be a smoke control will be there, lightning control will be there, and a fire and detection alarm system they are fixing, and a security access control, and a digital video CCTV cameras they are fixing it, and environmental control will be available, and a mechanical maintenance will be available. Then it will be on site, a technical service person should also be there, and it should be monitored by a system. Okay, it should be monitored by a system. This is nothing but building management system. This only you are going to study in this semester. Okay, are you understand my point? And to the main drawback here, to make this all the components inside the building, we have to invest more money. Okay, that is one drawback. But advantages are available. Advantages means security. Second one is less maintenance and cost effective, which is available, and also employee. Okay, employers are very much lesser. Okay, without employer, we can operate this entire system. Major topics. The first module is advanced PLC we are going to study. Second module is building management system, energy management system we are going to do. Third module is fire alarm system. Fourth one, CCTV. Fifth one is home automation system. These are the five modules we are going to discuss it in this semester. These are the textbooks. Okay, we are going to do. And for every material, I will share the materials to you. For every module and every lecture, the material will be shared, and immediately the recorded video will be updated in the YouTube. This is CAE pattern, 50 marks. SCE pattern will be 50 marks. There are three tests, CAE test, two assignments, quiz, two co-curricular, 10 marks will be available. Okay. Now first we are going to see the SCADA, module 1, SCADA. Any doubts? Any doubts? Till now you have no doubts. Okay. Now we will get into the module 1. SCADA. Okay. You see this person. See, the subject is more interesting, and I need some interaction from your people. Okay. You see this person. This person here. This picture will be taken in the year 1927, I think. 1927-28. Okay. There are the meters are there, and this person is monitoring it. Okay. He is monitoring a turbine plant. Okay, a gas turbine plant, he is monitoring it, and by using this devices he is just checking. Okay, this is the hold. Now you see this system, this picture. In this picture, the person not available, but they can monitor it by using the screen. Computers are there, by using the screen they can monitor it. This is the entire plant. Okay, entire plant they can monitor. For example, this is, you can take a thermal power plant. This power plant is having almost a generating station, transmission station, distribution station will be available, and how the plants will be, everything, all the layers are there. Okay, there will, a person will be sitting here and he can monitor it. He can monitor it. And if any problem is identifying, immediately, if any problem is there, immediately he can identify the problem, and he can inform to the person who is sitting there. That is nothing but SCADA. Okay, you see here, SCADA system is a collection of both software and hardware components that allow supervision. Supervision means a person who is sitting there, supervision and control of plants, both locally and remotely. Both locally means either you can sit and monitor it, or otherwise by using the mobile and you can monitor it. That is nothing but remote. Okay, in remote station also you can monitor it. Okay, this is a historical view. Okay, in 1950s, this is a historical view from today. In 1950s, this is a gas plant, okay, gas and oil plant, okay, will be there. And if they want to monitor, they have to go and they have to visit that plant, and if any problem is there, they have to identify. Okay, that is the case in previous. Okay, in the 1960s, what happened? They brought a telegram, a communication data cable. They brought it, and by using the that data cable is nothing but telegram, telemetry devices through phone. They will call and they will execute it. That is nothing but in 1960s. Okay, it is 1960s. It is happening. When it comes to 1970s will be there. What happened? They bought a PLC. What is PLC? Anyone? What is PLC? Yes, PLC, programmer logic controller, is nothing but by using the microprocessor and the microcontroller, they will write the program, and by using the wires, they will control it. Okay, they will control it. There will be a display devices will be there, they will monitor it. That is in 1970s they bought it. But in the year 1980s, what they've done? In 1990s, they bought a computer. Okay, instead of a small chip, they brought a computer. They connected with this computer through LAN, local area networking, and HMI. What is HMI? Anyone? HMI means what? Yes, yes. Human machine interface. Human machine interface means a person who is sitting before the computer, he should monitor it. Okay? That is human. Machine means the machine will be that this machine will be connected with the computer. That is machine. Interface, a human and a machine will be monitor the devices, the entire plant. That is nothing but interface. So human machine interface, in short name we can say it will be HMI. Okay, HMI in 1990s they bought it. Okay, yeah. From the year 1990s till 2000, the SCADA will be brought into the picture to connect the entire plant. The entire plant will be monitored by a computer. Okay, monitored by a computer. Now, if you take our home application, in our home, there are two bedrooms, kitchen, okay, dining hall, all the gadgets are available. Okay, portico, everything is there. Okay, now you are connected the camera. Okay, now you are going to monitor it. Okay, in the year 2000s, they are connected with the camera, and by using the computer, they will monitor it. That is the happening in 2000. And afterwards, nowadays what we'll do? Nowadays what we are doing it now? Without some devices we are using, right? To monitor the cameras, to monitor the videos. In mobile phones itself, we are monitoring, right? What is the logic it is? Anyone? Anyone? Through wireless, we are using, right? Through wireless, we are connecting with the mobile phones and we are monitoring the entire house. Okay, without connecting with the computer. That language, it is nothing but structured query language by using that SQL. SQL stands for structured query language. By using that language, the entire system will be monitored by using the wireless network. Okay, that is a wireless network. Okay, that is nothing but SCADA. Okay, SCADA stands for supervisory control and data acquisition, which monitor the entire system, okay, entire power plant, which will be applicable to any industry, okay, any industry, including hotel, home, and the textile industry, whatever it may be. SCADA, without SCADA, you need not to monitor the entire plant, entire factory. Okay, SCADA is very bad. That's what in the module we have included in module 1. Okay, this SCADA. Okay, what is basics of SCADA? Basics of SCADA. SCADA stands for supervisory control and data acquisition. Any doubts, ma'am? Till now, students. Students, any doubts? No. Whether speed is okay? The speed is okay? Okay. SCADA stands for Supervisory Control and Data Vision. It is the automation control system that is used in industry such as energy, oil and gas, water, power and etc. And this SCADA ranging from small scale industry to large scale industry depends upon the requirement. Okay, a major definition here, a SCADA system work by operating with signals that communicating via channel to provide a user means human with remote control of any equipment in a given system. And this SCADA can be operated by using the programmable logic controller PLC, register part and alarm statistics. Okay. Now what are the important, what are the advantages? One is to control the industrial process locally or at remote locations. Remote location means the industry will be located in somewhere. The person who is sitting in the center of the Bangalore, okay, but industry will be located in 65 kilometers away from the Bangalore. So we have to monitor it by using the SCADA application. And another one is, once it will be monitored, we have to gather the information and process. It will be a real-time data. We are going to process it. And third one, it will be directly interactive with the devices such as sensor, valve, pump, motor. Everything we are interconnecting it through a device called Human Machine Interface. HMI only we are interconnecting it. And once it will be interconnecting it, there will be a, we are recording the devices. For example, there are, what is that? Weather stations are there, right? Weather stations. Okay. Every state is having weather stations. Okay. Now, for example, there will be a one center will be located somewhere to monitor the sea, both the Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean also. Which center it is? Can you please anyone tell me? One center will monitor the entire sea of Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea and Indian Sea, Indian Ocean also. Which center it is? Anyone? Anirudh? Anyone? National Institute of Ocean Technology. Okay, NIOT is the authorized center which is situated in Chennai. That center will monitor the entire ocean, and this center will be sending the information to the government of India what happening inside the sea, what happening, whether tsunami will take place. Immediately the information will send it to the central government, then they will alert the state governments. This is the method. Previous, in the year 2004, the tsunami has been created and most of the people has been died. Okay, before that NIOT is not available. Okay, when the disaster happened, then only the central government of India started the NIOT center in Chennai, and this center will be the authorized agent for our country. Okay, that is nothing but SCADA, supervisory control and data vision. Okay, there are five important components are there in SCADA. One is HMI, Human Machine Interface. Second one is supervisory system. Third one is remote terminal units. Remote terminal unit stands for RTU. RTU stands for remote terminal units. Fourth one, programmable logic controller. Fourth one is programmable logic controller. Fifth one, communication infrastructure. These are the five important parts are available in SCADA system. Okay, now you see this diagram. This is the pictorial representation of this diagram. You see, this is the industry. This is an industry. This is the crane. Okay, now this crane is connected with the PLC. Okay, and this PLC is connected with the plant. Okay, now what happened? This PLC will get information from both plant as well as the industry equipment, and which will send the signal through an system that is nothing but SCADA device. It is a server, supervisory control and data machine. Okay, and how it will be processed means, in PLC there are different terms are available. Okay, that is nothing but RTU. RTU stands for transmission unit. Through transmission unit we are transferring. Okay, this SCADA, once this will monitor the signal, immediately it will be sent to the laptop or to our mobile phone. This is nothing but human machine interface. Okay, here they are monitoring the temperature. Okay, temperature of the given plant. Now why we have mentioned this signal? This is nothing but remote signal. Okay, this is nothing but a signal we are delivering it. Okay, any doubts? The theory which is available here, please go through that. Okay, you will understand it. This is a small block diagram for understandable purpose. I have included. Any doubts? Any doubts, students? Any doubts? Okay. This is I already completed. Okay. Now, in SCADA, there are different types of buttons are there. Okay, buttons are there to connect, to control it. That is nothing but push button switches we are operating. And you see this term, this is nothing but diagram. This is nothing but analog devices. It will be mobile devices, display devices. And the switch is also be there. These are the important parameters for in SCADA. Okay, to control the motor, there are push button switches will be connected it, and selector switches is also be connected. Okay, need of SCADA system. There are four important needs are available. One is alarm handling. Second one is trend curves pattern. Third one, data access and retrieval. Fourth one, computer networking and processing. Alarm handling. For example, in SCADA, there will be industry is available. In the industry, if any problem, okay, if any accident will be happened, the SCADA will identify the problem. Immediately, it will be given an alarm. Okay, that is nothing but alarm. So based upon the alarm, okay, then the person who is working inside the industry, then everybody will be alert. Okay, that is nothing but alarm handling. For the different types of accidents, there are different types of alarms they are setting it. And second one is trend curve pattern. Trend curve means there will be historical data. Okay, there will be a curves are there. You see here. Historical data means now in industry we have to get this type of curve. Okay, non-linear curve should get it. Okay, this is historical data. Okay, if any accident will be happen, instead of this curve, sometime it will be increased. This curve indicates accident. Okay, that is the meaning of trend curve pattern. Okay, trend curve pattern. Fourth one is data access. Okay, how we have to access the data? Whether it will be in any network, okay, it will be in terms of SQL, we can call it as SQL program, as well as it should be reported in high level. Okay, high level. So once you will get this curve, we have to make it as a data in a table. In table format we have to put it, for every second we have to put, and we have to give on the data to the higher levels. and the computer networking and the processing. It is nothing but it will be called as a LAN connection, local area network, LAN connections, and it will be monitored by using the server. Okay, it is monitored by using the server. So there are four types of needs are available. One is alarm handling. Second one is trend curve pattern. Third one is data access. Fourth one is computer networking and processing. These are the need of SCADA system. And some other needs are also be available. Can you please note them? The first one is, if we are operating the SCADA in power station, means if we implement the SCADA, why we need SCADA system? Can anyone tell me? In industry, for example, in electrical industry, you are generating the electrical energy in any thermal or power plant. Now they are going to monitor it by using the SCADA. So there are power theft of them. Okay, so there will be more increasing in power theft. Because of that, I need SCADA. Second one, there will be a labor. Labor are very high. Okay, more labor, so the cost wise it is high. Okay, so to reduce it, I need SCADA. Third one, time. Time consumption is more here, so to avoid it, I need SCADA. Fourth point is, there is no automation system in the government sector, so they have to improve automation. Okay, they want to improve automation, so I need SCADA system. And fifth one, customer services should be easy. So for that I need SCADA system. Okay, customer services should be easy. Then only I need SCADA system. Benefits of SCADA. What are the benefits if you implement the SCADA? Increasing life of the equipment. Second, labor cost. We can reduce the labor cost. Third, increased compliances. And fourth one, no requirement of large capital investment. Fifth one, many automation companies are using SCADA to provide access to real-time data. Sixth one is, it gives more flexibility. It gives more flexibility to choose the equipment. Any doubts? Till now? Advantages, you see, it will be monitored from a remote location also. It will be reduce the cost, logging of the data, alarms, everything. Okay. Thank you. Any doubts?